Hi, Super Mario Miss is back with a review that's gonna be a little bit long review because I'm gonna show you my Famicom games. Later on I will make a review of games that I have to Nintendo 8-bit and Super Nintendo 8-bit, but this time it's Famicom games that I'm using on my Dendy system. I'm gonna start with the games that I have in box first. I'll start here. This is Mario Open Golf. It's not the first golf game that came with many systems. This is a little bit different game, a little bit more advanced. Mario Open Golf. And here is a picture of it on the back. You can see it has a cut here. That something has, it's a scratch. So there you have it. Mario Open Golf cost 1800 yen. And I don't know what currency that is in English. Mario Open Golf, next out, Tetris 2 and Plus Bomblis. This game I also got to the SNES, the Super Nintendo. A review of that will be available later on. That's the back of Tetris 2, and of course the cartridge is inside. Next game I'm gonna show you, Star Force. Good game, Star Force. Next up, a clone of Tetris, Hatris. This game is actually a little bit difficult to play, I think. But it is BPS that I've given it out, the same company that give out the original Tetris. This is Hatris. Moving on to a really good game. If you can get your hands on this one, I recommend it. Look it up on YouTube if you want to see a review of the actual game. This is Quart. It's a sort of a space-themed Tetris game. And this game is really good. This is the back of the game. You have to shoot away different shapes of blocks to make it disappear with your ship. And there is a little line. I don't know if you can make it out on the camera here. If the bricks come down to the line, it's game over. Good game. Recommend it a lot. Quart was the name of that game. Next up, everybody knows this one. Dr. Mario. I also got Dr. Mario on the 8-bit system. That's a later review on the European system. I also got this, of course. Good game, good fun. It's a sort of a Tetris game there with pills instead. Next up, Yoshi's Cookie. Yeah, I like the games when Yoshi are alone because I think Mario is in too many games. And I also got a game called Mario and Yoshi to the 8-bit European system, and I managed to get the USA version instead of the European, because the game in the United States is called Yoshi, not Mario and Yoshi. I think Yoshi should have more games, because I think he's a little bit in the background, and I think Yoshi are much more cooler than Mario. Balloon Fight! Balloon Fight. It's an old game. And I can recommend it. It's a classic. You can also play Adam and Eve on the Caltron 6-in-1 or Myriad 6-in-1, but I don't care about that game. I think this is better. This is the original Balloon Fight. And on the Myriad version, you got the Harry Belafonte team going through the Balloon Fight, their version of Balloon Fight game, and I don't think that's good enough. Next up, Clue Clue Land. I can recommend that as well. Clue Clue Land. And I got one more game in the box before I go on to the games without the box. Classic Pinball. You can see the box are a little bit weird off. It's an old game. It's Pinball. I also got this on the other console as well, the European one. First I'm gonna show you some games that are a little bit bigger than the original game. This is Golf, by the way. And if I take the game Exerion, you can see they are a little bit bigger. Namco came out with some bigger games. Why they have bigger cartridges, I don't know. This is Golf. Very quickly further on, I have a racing game, Race 91 or something like that. I don't remember the full name, and I'm not going to look up for it now. And I got one more of the big cartridge. This one is a good game. Mappy 2. I didn't know that MAPI 2 was existing until I find this cartridge abroad on an auction abroad. So this is the follow-up to MAPI. So, and this is actually an adventure game instead of that you are moving around in a house. This is actually a pretty good game. If you can get your hands on this one, I recommend it a lot. It says MAPI 2 on the top, the etiquette is a little bit weird off. There's nothing to see on the back, so MAPI 2. Now, normal cartridges. Exerion, good game from Jaleco. This game I don't know the name of. It's a space game, space shooting game. I can't remember on the top of my head what the name of this game is. Doesn't matter. Okay, you probably know when I show you the cartridge. Next up, you have the MAPI game, the first one. As you can see, this is a pirate cartridge because you have Jerry in the front and a dog. But the game is MAPI, so that's okay. It works perfectly fine. And this is a Russian copy, by the way. It works perfectly fine anyway, so I don't care. Terminator. Here, the producer of the game have done something... I think they had done something wrong, because it's not Terminator inside. It's Power Blade. It doesn't matter, because the Terminator game is a piece of crap. So, I'm happy to have Power Blade in this instead. Why they call it Terminator? I don't know. Maybe they find out that the Terminator game was a piece of shit, so they decided to take Power Blade inside it instead. Doesn't matter. It works perfectly well. Road Rash 3. Yeah, it's Road Rash. It's a racing game. It's a little bit violent game as well. So you probably played Road Rash on the Sega Mega Drive. Spartan. Spartan 3. Kung Fu game. Spartan 1 is the Kung Fu game we know in Europe. The other versions of Spartan was never released outside of Europe as far as my knowledge goes. Tetris Flash. Good game. And I also got this on the Super Nintendo. This is actually the Famicom version of the game. Tetris Flash. Good game. Recommend it a lot. Next up. Ice Climber. Classic. In the start, when the Nintendo was giving out the consoles in the beginning of the 80s, this game here was following every consoles in Europe and America, as far as I know. Ice Climber. Later on, Super Mario Bros. Was the one that was released together with the console, but this is the first one. And if you got a console back in the days when this was the cart that follows the system, Ice Climber, you probably have a console that was never region locked either. You can use games from all regions natively in it. And this is Ninja 3. This is a ninja game given out in Europe as well. Under another name, it's from Hudson Soft. The game is decent and a little bit hard to play, but it's a decent game. Next up, Tiny Toon 3 contains Tiny Toon 3. That's simple. Further on, 116 in one. I am not a fan of pirate cartridges, but I have a few of them because some of the games that I really want is not possible to get original. If I get the original in the future, I will buy it, but I have a few cartridges with several games in one just to get some of the games. So this contains Mario 4, for example, a Pokemon game, Tetris. Well, it's good enough. I have one more of it, 132 in one, 37, sorry. And this game also contains Jewel Tetris. That's one of my favorite Tetris. It's better than Columns, I can guarantee you that. Maybe in the future I will show you that on the television, this game. Further on, I have one more pirate game here, 76 in one. This contains a version of Harry Potter that I actually think is nifty to play. So that's the reason why I have this. Hot Blood Sports. It is an RPG game. Why they use sports in the title, I don't know. It's an RPG game. Tetris, the first Tetris to the system. Burger Time, good game, classic Burger Time. Nuts and Milk, I can recommend this game as well. It's very entertainment and addicting, and I have played this to the death, that's for sure. I played it a lot. This is the original golf game, the first golf game that came out on the Nintendo. Not so good today if you look at the graphics and so on, but it's a classic. Chase HQ, this is a racing game that I don't know how to play properly because I think it's a little bit hard. It contains the game called Chase HQ. I don't know if Chase is HQ stands for headquarters or whatnot. I'm not sure. I don't know. I have to tilt it up here. Super Smash TV. It contains Super Smash TV in 8-bit version. Good game, very violent game actually, and a hard game, hard as heck. But I can recommend you a copy of this on the Dendy or Famicom as well. I recommend it, it's good enough. Kickle Cubicle from Irem. Good game, great. Captain America. It's Captain America. Darkwing Duck 2. This game is actually Probotector 2 or Contra 2 with Darkwing Duck in the main role instead of these soldiers. So this is a pirate. It's a little bit funny. It's a novelty to have anyway. Darkwing Duck 2. Ninja. It contains a ninja game. As you can see, they use the front from a game called Dragon's Lair, but it is a ninja game inside. So, okay, it's a pirate way to go, but it's not far off anyway. One more pirate cartridge, 168 in one. Year best-selling card, it says, 1995. This is actually pretty good and contains a lot of big games, actually, so this is a good buy. Over there with it, further on. Doraemon, good adventure game, little bit hard. But you get the hang of it very quickly. It's a very good game. Doraemon. It's a Hudson Soft release. Adventure Island. A little bit off picture, but it is Adventure Island. I have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 on it on Game Boy Advance SP as well. I like these games. The first Super Adventure Island is a little bit hard to play. They made that game a little bit too hard, after my opinion, because the second one and further on, it was better play and you can easier get through the game. But the first one is a little bit hard to play through. But when you played it something for a while, you will manage that. Devil World, it's Devil World. Classic. Adventure Island 3. As I mentioned, I have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 of this game. This is the third one in the series. Wrecking Crew, great classic. I can recommend this. This is the first Mario game called Mario Bros. It's Mario Bros. Nothing more to say about that. This is Contra Probotector with big cheat menu. For Dendy Famicom, of course. The label has been weird off. It was not properly glued, so I have to write on it. This has a cheat menu inside that you can enter. You can choose weapons, choose how much life you want to have during the game, and you can choose even to have, for example, the laser weapon through the whole entire game. So this is a cool version. It's a pirate version. I don't care. It's cool and it works perfectly fine. First Super Mario Bros. There's nothing more to say about it. I don't have Super Mario 2 to it. That's because on Famicom, the Super Mario 2 is called Doki Doki Panic. You have a Super Mario 2 as well, but it looks like the first one with some differences, that's all. Kickmaster. As you can see, Jim Carrey from The Mask is at the front, but the game is Kickmaster inside. And I like that because Kickmaster is a very good fighting game. And I can recommend it a lot. Just look away from Jim Carrey here because that's not correct because this is a pirate cartridge. But it is Kickmaster. Star Soldier, great game. I can recommend it a lot. Next up, this is Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2, the arcade game. The first one was never released on Famicom. This is the arcade game. Works perfectly fine. This is also a sort of a pirate cartridge because it doesn't have a title on the top. Doesn't matter, it works perfectly fine, no issues with it. And this is Turtles 2. Here's some guff on the back. Try to get it if you can. Further on, Super Mario 3. This is the third in the series, Super Mario 3. I think this label is cool, it actually represented the game. Lovely. I like it a lot. Yeah, Super Mario 3. Further on, Mad Max. It contains Mad Max. It's a little bit hard game, a little bit confusing game if you don't have seen the movies before you play the game. But anyway, it's a good game. This is also from Russia. You can see it on the shape here. And the tape at the side here is from the store, probably to secure it so you don't open it and alter it if you wanna put it in to the store again and change to another game. I don't know. Something like that. This is Mad Max. Yoshi, the egg game. Then you know what I'm talking about. It's not Mario and Yoshi. This is a different game with only Yoshi in the main role. And I'm happy for that. So that's Yoshi for you. This is Yoshi. I don't remember the name of this on the top of my head. Is it only Yoshi or something? I don't remember. Later on, Disneyland. It contains a Disney game with Mickey and Peter and so on, but I don't remember what the game real name of the game is. It's a good game, and it says it's a golden card at the bottom. It's Disneyland. The Punisher. I have the light gun. The Punisher is a very good game. You can also play it without the light gun, but you have to use the aim and you have to use the D-pad, so it's a little bit harder to play and you can't get so high score as you wish when you have a light gun. But at least LJN was thinking a little bit ahead, because at one point the light gun will not be used. You cannot use it on flat screens and so on, but you can still use the game. So that's good thinking, and it's a good game from LJN actually. One of the few games that are really good from LJN. A classic one, Galaga. If you don't have this game, get it. That's the only thing I can say, Galaga. And this is the number 5 in the series of classic games to the system. So that's nifty enough. This is Galaga. We go further on. Now I'm gonna show you some of my real good classic favorites. This one has been given out on Commodore 64 as well. This is Arkanoid. Arkanoid, 52 levels, very good game, and a very good ending music on this game actually. I have beat this game. It's not easy, trust me when I say that. It's given up a title, and I also got the sequel to this game. I got Arkanoid 2, the second one. It's also from title, Arkanoid 2. This is number 16 in the series, I can see. The previous one doesn't have any number, so that was weird. Arkanoid 1 and Arkanoid 2. I can recommend both of those games. The second one is a little bit harder, but it's fun as heck. This one I show you with the Dendy, it's King Kong 2. James and Mike Mondays recently made a review of this game. So this is a good game and I can recommend it a lot, from Konami of course. I have two gold cartridges as well. Super Sevius. This is a golden cartridge. And I think it's a very nifty one. Zelda in Europe, Legend of Zelda and Adventure Link was also a gold cartridge. This was Super Sevius. I have one more. Very good adventure game. Dragon Buster. Great game as well. Further on, this is a really golden in my collection. Pokemon 2-in-1, and it contains Pokemon game, believe it or not, for the Famicom. And one of the game is actually also a pirate copy. It's actually Felix the Cat, but with Pokemon instead in the main role. And I think that's actually a very good thinking because of power-ups and something like that. If you want to see a review on Felix the Cat, you have to search on YouTube. This is 2-in-1, by the way, and this is a great game. I love it, and I'm happy to get this game. It's hard to get, let me tell you that right away, because it's a very new game on the Famicom system. Over there with it, sports game, basketball. This is a good RPG game, Ninja Brothers. It has English text in the game on a Japanese cartridge. I recommend it a lot. This is a good RPG game. If you like Mario RPG, you will like this as well. This is pretty good. Recommend it a lot. Ninja Brother. Or Ninja Brothers. Tengen Tetris. This is a little bit special because the Tengen Tetris was never released on the Famicom. You have to find it as a pirate cartridge. And the front picture of this is actually taken from a Tetris version on a Microsoft 95. Back in the school days, I played this version that you can see a picture of here on a computer. You get a normal diskette and it contains 9 different games, and one of the 9 games was this one. And I am very good at Tetris, so I beat everyone in the class on Tetris, and they were furious because I managed to get so far with the score as I did. But anyway, this is Tengen Tetris with Windows 95 Tetris logo at the front. It works perfectly fine, but that's the way you have to do it when the game was never released officially on Famicom. 66-in-1 is a pirate game again. It's a version of Harry Potter here that makes me keep this game. And it also has Bomberman on it and other games, so that's okay. Over there with it. Tennis. Classic tennis. Nintendo Tennis. That's okay. Everybody has seen that game before. Mac Rider. Very fast motorcycle game. Mac Rider. Horse racing game. You bet and hope that your horse is winning. From Namco. Or Namco, if you like. Egypt, puzzle game, recommend it. It's given out by Human Corporations. I have never heard of that before I get this cartridge, but it's a good game with good graphic. See if you can search it up and find it. This is Gradius from Konami. Let's see if I can get it clearer here. Konami, Gradius. Good game. You can use the Konami code on it and get some weapons, extra weapons on the game. Jurassic Park. It contains the first 8-bit version of Jurassic Park. I also got this game on the NES, not on the SNES, unfortunately, but I have it on NES. The same game as this. Jurassic Park. I put it over there. We are getting through here. Dig Dug 2, the second one. Dig Dug, the sequel to Dig Dug 1. This one is a good arcade game, I can guarantee you that. Number 14 it says, Dig Dug 2, if you like the first one, you will love this one, because it has better graphic and good two-player mode, and you can do a lot more in this game. You can even destroy a whole entire island with enemies, where the whole entire island goes in the sea. I recommend this a lot. Dig Dug 2, or Dig Dug 2, yeah. Mario 9. It's a gold card again. You can see it has some prints from Super Mario Party, but it is a pirate version of Mario 9 from another game. Look it up on YouTube and you can just type in Mario 9 and you will see the game. Further on, Space Shadow. It's a space gun game. Tiny Toon 4. It's Tiny Toon, number 4 in the series. Magic Kingdom. It says on the front, it's a weird picture. It is Magic Kingdom, but it is a Disney game. And it doesn't look like a Disney game on the cartridge here. But it is Magic Kingdom. Favorite game? Magmax. I have beaten this game. And get through it. It's a good game. It's a good space game as well. I recommend it a lot. It's Magmax. Not Mad Max, but Magmax. Top Gun 2. The one that you can play two-player on and hunt each other. It's a good game. I can recommend it. It's much better than the first one. That says a lot. Chip 'n Dale, called Grand Combat. That's because it is a pirate cartridge, but it is Chip 'n Dale 1. I have one more of this, I come to that later. First, 3-in-1, this has Aladdin, Contra 2, the second in the series, and it got Street Fighter on it. And all three games are very good, and this is a very heavy cartridge as well, because it contains three very big games. If you can hunt it up, I can recommend it. DP66 is the model number on this one. 3-in-1. We are almost done. Tom and Jerry. Weird looking cover or inlay. A scared cat and a rather angry mouse. Doesn't matter because it's Tom and Jerry. It works perfectly fine. Next up, Girudin, classic helicopter game. I'd rather play this one than Tiger Heli. I like Girudin better. Number 6. And this is a very old cartridge in the series. This is says Disneyland at the front. It's not Disneyland at all. This is Bugs Bunny's Blowout. Yeah, Bugs Bunny Blowout. Birthday Blowout, I think it's the name of this. Weird game. Easy game to play. And it's okay. Bugs Bunny Birthday Blowout. Fighting game, Carnov. Yeah, contains Carnov. Goonies 2, the second in the series of Goonies. This is a very good game. You can see Fratelli here and the kids on the top here. So this is Goonies 2 for you there. A good game, very good game. This I have beat several times. Combat! From Jaleco, classic UFO game, Combat. Get to the goal. It's much like Frontline. I have one more of Super Mario, the first game. That's because this is a newer version of it, because the other one is beginning to be weird of. It's a little bit hard to start up. So I bought this, and this I can just put right in and it starts up. It's a newer version, barely used. And as I said, further on I have one Grand Combat here again, but with a redder or orange cartridge this time. I have two of this as well. One more game to show you. Atlantis No Nazo. A little bit weird game, and I'm a little bit disappointed that bullets from your weapon are arching over the enemy. This is a game that angry video game nerd should really look at. He will be furious over this, but it's somehow playable as well from Sunsoft. That was the last game I have to show you of my Famicom collection. I hope you like it, and thank you for watching, and have a nice evening. Bye!